Hello everyone, it's Galina for Studio Katya. Today I want to share with you two fun tech ideas. I'm going to use one set of dice for both of my techs. This set called Dotted Shaker Die Set Number 1. It consists of three dice, which you can use separately, but I didn't remove a smallest die for making holes in the techs. So, using this die set, I cut out two small tech panels, a solid one for attack background and attack with rectangular window. It will be my front panel. On this front panel tech, I'm applying distress oxide inks. My camera was wobbling a little bit during the inking process, so I skip it in the video, sorry about that. I simply applied shaded lilac color on the bottom and tumbling glass color on the top of the panel. After the ink blending, I added a lot of colorful drops on the tech. I used same inks for that. Now I want to decorate the inner part of the tech. I'm going to use a sentiment stamp from Birthday Greetings stamp set and some images from Artsy Trimming stamp set. I place the Artsy Trimming set on a smaller acrylic block because I'm going to use only a part of the large image. First, I'm stamping the sentiment with black ink. Next, I can figure out where to stamp the other images. With same black Memento ink, I'm stamping some crafty tools under the sentiment. I used black Memento ink because I want to color these images with Copic markers. And Memento ink is a Copic friendly ink. I start coloring with two yellow markers. This paint tube is quite small, so I will make a super simple shading with two and three markers. At first, I'm applying the lightest shade of each color. Then I'm applying a darkest color to add more contrast on the panel. I colored the other tools with pink and green markers. On the some bottoms, I applied a light blue color. And I finished the coloring by adding a dark gray shadows around each tool on the small panel. Next, I foam mount the front tech panel on the white tech background. In the center, I am placing the small colored panel. I attached it with liquid glue. Can't leave without embellishment even a small tech. So I'm adding a few different size sequins. This sequin mix called Crystal Clear Fusion and it's so beautiful. I'm attaching sequins with Studio Katya liquid glue. And in the end, I will add some ribbons. For my second tag, I'm going to use a same tag die. You can combine the tag die with any other nesting dies you may have. Here I'll be using a small oval die from Nested Oval Die Sets from Studio Katya. I cut out a white tag for the background and one tag with oval window from the bright yellow cardstock. This cardstock has some tiny embossed dots, I think it's from Basil Basics. Between these two parts, I'm going to place one more die cut. From the light yellow cardstock, I cut out a small piece with hexagon using micro hexagon cover plate die. I didn't want to leave the white space behind the hexagon die cut, so I decided to apply distress inks on the white tag background. I'm using distress oxide inks, they called cracked pistachio and tempered glass. Next, I'm going to add a cute bee on the tag. I stamped a little bee with a flower using Memento ink. And I'm going to cut it out using coordinating die. To color this bee, I'm using a classic bee color palette. To color stripes on the bee, I prefer to use a dark gray color instead of a black. To color the flower, I pick some blue markers, B32, B34, and B37. I will create a nice shading on the flower. Next, I'm going to add a small sentiment on the tag. I'm using a stamp from Peony Trimmings and coordinating stripe die. With clear embossing ink, I'm stamping a sentiment on the black cardstock. I covered the stamped image with a white embossing powder and I'm going to melt it with a heat gun. After that, I run the stamped image with a stripe die through my die cutting machine and I get a nice stripe banner die cut. On the back side of the front yellow tag, I'm applying liquid glue and then I'm attaching the hexagon die cut. Next, I'm adding a foam tape to attach the front tag on the white tag background. Also, I attach the bee and the sentiment on the tag. And I want to put a beautiful crystal heart in the bee hands or paws, I'm not sure about the correct word. Anyway, the bee looks even more adorable with holding this crystal. At last, I'm adding colorful ribbons on the decks. I love to hold the ribbons with a twine and tie a little bow. Here are my finished two tags. They will be a perfect addition to the presents. With such tags, I can keep the gift wrapping super simple, and I love that I can add as many ribbons as I want, because this tag die has a perfect size hole on the top. I hope you like these tag ideas. Full supply list you can find in the video description below, as well as link to the blog where you can find more inspiration. Thank you for joining me today. See you soon. Bye!